materials are actually inside. See, this means the package will be returned to its sender.
Yeah, okay, whatever. Oh, listen, these are your last words in this big scene, okay? Now, which is more important, getting Billy to send this map to your archaeologist wife or some postal regulation? Everyone, we're going again! We're going out back to one! Here we go!
Action!
Billy, come closer, Billy. Now, put this in a box that doesn't have...
Oh, for the love of God!
Ever been in a situation where you wish you had a pause button?
You know, you push a button, the scene freezes, and you take the right action.
Maybe even prevent a crime.
Well, guess what? You don't need to push a button.
When it comes to preventing sexual assault, just look out for your friends.
Is your buddy not taking no for an answer? Say something before things get out of hand.
Is your friend cornered by a guy who's putting his hands all over her? Step in, use an excuse, and get her out of there.
Preventing sexual assault is part of your duty.
Find out more at myduty.mil.
Now, an important message from President Obama to all potentially on the planet.
If you're one of the millions of people right now who are worried about getting fired, don't despair. A recent Boston Globe story highlighted two people who were pleasantly surprised by unemployment during my recession. These people, who had climbed the success spiral during the Bush years, are truly enjoying my failure free fall. Under George Bush, unemployment would have been a catastrophe. But under my administration, it is an enlightening experience. You'll find that you will see life in a whole new way. You'll have all the time you want to go to the park and play with the kids, take long walks, and learn that the best things in life are free, like mortgages and health care. Right now, I'm doing all I can to help as many Americans as possible to experience the joys of unemployment. So when you get that pink slip, don't ruin your happiness by looking for a job. Together, we can do it. Yes, we can.
On the Rush Limbaugh Show, Mark Stein sitting in. Don't wait for Obama's amnesty, by the way. I'll amnesty to you today if you call in. 1-800-282-2882. Complimentary Black Friday amnesties. I'm running off green cards in the basement here. It can be yours within 48 hours. Why wait? Why wait for Obama's? What's better than pardoning a turkey, by the way? In Seattle, the mayor... Ed Murray pardoned a tofurkey who has been he had a big ceremonial tofurkey pardoning ceremony in Seattle, and I don't know what's happened to this tofurkey since. He's probably been sent to live in a tofurkey wildlife refuge somewhere. Barack Obama spent Thanksgiving, this new thing that's come along now, where every holiday or every key day in the American calendar, because they do it with 9/11 too, has to be turned into a day of service. So Obama spent part of his Thanksgiving day serving at a soup kitchen. I don't know whether he pardoned the soup. We'll have our researchers, our vast research team, look into that and see if we can establish whether he pardoned the soup. I don't know whether it's Black Friday at the soup kitchen, but if you're in the neighborhood, swing by and check it out, because they may have 70% off gruel today, so you don't want to miss out on that. But I trust wherever you are, you had an enjoyable Thanksgiving, as they did last year. This is another annual tradition that seems to have taken off. Democrats and liberal groups issued talking points for Thanksgiving, because as they see it, dinner with your family is just another photo op where it's important to stay on message. So this morning, many of you liberals may have a few Obama talking points left over from yesterday that you didn't have a chance to slip in between the turkey and the pumpkin pie. So instead of just putting your talking points in the blender, and making talking point soup, why not call 1-800-282-2882 and recycle your feeble Obama talking points with us. Martha Stewart will be joining us in the second hour to talk about how you can cut up your leftover Obama talking points, and just with a few pine cones and holly berries, you can make them into an attractive centerpiece for your Christmas buffet. But if you don't want to wait that long, then just call 1-800-282-2882 and recycle your lame Obama talking points with us right now. After Ferguson, police are twitchy and they're taking no chances. From CBS News, Grand Junction, Colorado, a man is facing a felony menacing charge because two Colorado sheriff's deputies say they thought a banana he pointed at them was a gun. Nathan Rolf Channing, 27, was arrested Sunday, according to the Grand Junction Daily Sentinel. According to an arrest affidavit, deputies Joshua Bunch and Donald Love said Channing pointed the fruit at them while crossing a street. The deputies said they feared for their lives, even though they saw that the object was yellow. Bunch wrote in the affidavit that he has seen handguns in many shapes and colors. He wrote that Love was drawing his service weapon when Channing of Fruitvale, Colorado, yelled, "It's a banana." Yes, the man accused of pointing a banana at police is from Fruitvale, and yes, one of the police officers he pointed the banana at is named Bunch. And no, we didn't make this up. That's from CBS News. I didn't know you could get a... This officer says that you can get a handgun in yellow. I didn't know that, actually. Is that just like those dainty little ladysmiths for the female heat packer who want something that will accessorize with a leopard skin coat? Or in hunting season, are the woods full of canary yellow rifles and muzzle loaders? Who knew? Presumably, right now, there are 12-point bucks standing all over the woods of northern New Hampshire saying to each other, did I just see the sun catching the glimmer of a gun barrel over there? Nah, relax, that's just a very long, very straight banana sailing through the air. Pay no attention to it. Anyways, good news for John Kerry, because next time he goes on one of those hunting photo ops he does when he's running for president. If you remember that from 2004, when he... where was he? He walked into some store in Ohio or Iowa, and he goes, "Where can I get me a hunting license?" Because that's how real men talk, of course. Where can I get me a hunting license? Because I want to go a hunting. That's what he said when he walked into the Iowa General Store. Where can I get me a hunting license? But the good news now is when he's doing one of those photo ops the next time he's running for president, and why not, he can get a gun in the same nice, sharpy, bright color as those electric yellow buttock-hugging lycra shorts he likes to wear when he goes windsurfing off Nantucket. Mauve Magnum. Well, there is a gay group. There's gay... Before we tiptoe too far down that primrose path and make any lame puns about the police worried that they were confronting a dangerous fruit, there is actually a gay group called the Pink Pistols. But as far as I know, their pistols are not actually pink. It's just a it's just a bit of poetic license in the name of the group. I didn't know you could get pink pistols, and it's news to me that you can get them in yellow too. But apparently the big takeaway from this is that it's illegal to point a banana at law enforcement, as Harry Belafonte sang, "Come, Mr. Copperman, take down me banana. Sheriff, come and be one, go home." Oh, Mae West, is that a banana in your pocket, or are you just displeased to see me? I don't want to be Hispanophobic about this, because but it's come to something that everything now is Hispanic in America. Once upon a time, your two-bit punk in Colorado would be packing a Smith & Wesson. And now he's like packing the Chiquita heater. Bring it on, copy, you'll never take me alive. But that's the big news out of Colorado, that this guy has been arrested, but they felt he was threatened by a banana. And in the affidavit, they claim to have seen banana-colored and shaped handguns. Maybe for the poor guys we're sending all the way over to West Africa to cure Ebola, maybe they'd be bored. I assume it's some state-of-the-art thing that our special forces, when they go into danger, when they're on undercover operations, they have these special guns that are disguised as bananas. But apparently, maybe they have drones, armed drones now, that are disguised as a huge bunch of bananas flying over the skies of Yemen and Waziristan. But that's what it's come to, folks. They have weaponized bananas now.
Introducing a breakthrough in time management technology. A whole new day of the week. It's called Someday. It's ingenious. Perhaps someday you were going to go skydiving. Enter a hot dog eating contest. Maybe ride a mechanical bull. Now is on the calendar. You may want to retire someday. Ready for that? Then you'll really want a My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits, plan for your retirement, and how to save for it. If you already receive benefits, you can manage them online. Millions of people already have a My Social Security account. In fact, someone opens one about every 6 seconds. You should get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
He was a real soldier who always wanted to be the best. He led by example. He just loved his guys.
June 21st, 2006. Army Staff Sergeant Jared Monty was part of a 16-man patrol moving through the rugged Afghan mountains when they were attacked by as many as 50 insurgents. Directing his men to take cover behind a rock formation, the enemy so close he could hear their whispers, Monty called in artillery fire and personally stopped attempts by the enemy to flank the patrol. When he saw one of his men lying wounded on the open ground, Monty insisted that he would be the one to give aid.
He's my soldier. I'm going to go get him. Cover fire!
Monty ran into the firestorm, making three attempts to rescue his buddy. The last attempt, he was mortally wounded. For his actions, Monty was posthumously awarded the Medal of Honor. Jared Monty, an American hero.
This is NIH Health Matters.
The body's in. Influences, like viral or bacterial infections, or any other.
Autoinflammatory and autoimmune diseases are both diseases a rheumatologist treats, and they are both diseases caused by a dysregulation of the immune system.
Dr. Rafaela Goldbach-Mansky at the National Institute of Arthritis and Musculoskeletal and Skin Diseases writes in a recent issue of the New England Journal of Medicine about a newly discovered and rare autoinflammatory syndrome.
We identified a novel disease that occurs in children at the time they are born and is life-threatening, particularly in the early months of life.
For details, visit www.nih.gov. Health Matters is produced by the National Institutes of Health, part of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Hey, all, this is Big D.
And I'm Bubba.
And so excited to be on American Forces Radio Network.
That's right, the Big D and Bubba Show on AFN's Today's Best Country.
That's right, you can hear us live from 3 to 7 a.m. Pacific. 3 to 7 a.m. Pacific, Monday through Friday.
Get your country on, tune us in. You'll be glad you did.
Big D and Bubba now on AFN's Today's Best Country.
Available on your AFN decoder.
For official release, the Real Warriors campaign is a multimedia public awareness campaign designed to encourage 2021.
Service members, veterans, and families, get the health and wellness information you need through Real Warriors Live Chat. It's a free online chat service available 24/7. A trained consultant is ready to talk, listen, and guide you towards available resources. Check it out for yourself at realwarriors.net/livechat. And that's the bottom line.
We now return to Mark Stein here on the Rush Limbaugh program.
Yeah, Rush is sleeping off Thanksgiving today, but he will be back in action live on Monday. And don't forget, if you are a Rush 24/7 subscriber, if you go to rushlimbaugh.com and you become a Rush 24/7 subscriber, you need not be discombobulated by sinister foreign guest hosts. You can get Rush at any hour of the day you need him. You can also subscribe to the Limbaugh letter.
And in this month's edition of the Limbaugh Letter, by the way, he has an interview with me. I'm plugging my new book, and he's very kind enough to call it a must-read book, and it's called The Undocumented Mark Stein. That adjective will qualify me. Basically, the Senate is allowed to determine the rules. You have the Chief Justice there, who was at the time Rehnquist in the Clinton impeachment trial, and he basically didn't do anything except he picked out. He had this sort of Gilbert and Sullivan outfit made up for him. He didn't just wear his regular black robe. He wore this one with little frilly decorative bits up and down the sleeves. And once he designed his Gilbert and Sullivan robe, that was the last thing he did. Everything else, the senators all decided. And they determined the rules of the trial. And basically, that's why it went nowhere, because they wouldn't let the prosecutors, the House guys, the guys from the House, have this or that witness, you know. They wanted to bring on, at one point, they wanted to bring on all the women who had accused Clinton, fairly serious accusations. All these ones who are marked down as Jane Doe number 3 in the Star Report, and all these Democrat big shots like Jay Rockefeller the Fourth, John D. Rockefeller the Fourth, who's just retired now from West Virginia, said there was no way you were going to be seeing, you know, Jay Rockefeller the Fourth meeting Jane Doe number 3 on the floor of the United States Senate. It wasn't going to happen. Monica Lewinsky, they heard her testimony in private. They agreed to call her, but she couldn't come into the floor of the Senate and testify. And so nobody saw except for me, who happened to be staying in the same hotel as her. I was staying at the Mayflower, and my editors complained bitterly about the cost of the Mayflower versus the Econo Lodge around the back of the freight yards. And then Monica Lewinsky flew into town, and the minute it turned out I was the only correspondent, impeachment trial correspondent, with Monica Lewinsky staying in my hotel, they stopped complaining about the cost of my room service charges. And she was... so I got to see Monica at breakfast. In fact, I think one time I pressed the elevator button, and it slid open, and she was there in it. And I said, going down? Anyway, that was last time's impeachment trial, and it went... And it went nowhere. And it went nowhere because the Senate sets the rules. So here we would have a situation where 45 or 46 Democrat senators would set the rules for an impeachment trial, and then a handful of squishy Republicans, you know, the nice lady from Maine and whoever else, would all start saying, "Well, no, we're going a bit wobbly on this and all the rest of it." He ought to be impeached, but impeachment is one of many things that does not work. And you can take the view, Clara, that it would be an honorable thing to impeach him, and then sit back and get clobbered electorally, as would probably happen to the Republicans if they did do that. What worries me is that they won't even, you know, you're trying to drag them to impeach the president. And just to be clear here, I regard this as an absolutely lawless thing he did. And I do that because I'm in the system. So I absolutely loathe what he's done on U.S. immigration, as every legal immigrant does. He said, by the way, listen to the terms of this thing, he said. 5 years. If you've been here illegally for 5 years, you can get this special amnesty that will entitle you to a green card. That's quicker than legal immigration. The first time I ever spoke to a U.S. immigration lawyer, and he told me about all these systems, all these programs you can get in on, and it's all, there's a three-year waiting processing time for that. There's a six-year processing time for this. There's 10-year processing times for some legal immigration programs. So what he's done is the same thing as he did in his statement after Ferguson. Is when it comes to dividing up the two groups in society, he incentivizes the lawless and penalizes the lawful. That's what he does, whether we're talking about immigration or Ferguson or anything else. That's what this president does. Is this Republican Party going to impeach him? No, they're not, Clara. Look, we can't even get them. I pointed this out a few days ago after it was mooted that the president should not be invited to give the speech in the House of Representatives, the State of the Union. He's just insulted the legislative branch by saying, "I'm the legislative branch. I'll legislate." That's what he told those guys in Chicago. "I change the law." The House of Representatives should say, "Well, you can't change the law. That's what we do. And as long as you're going around talking like that, you ain't coming to give any speech in our chamber, in the people's chamber." Imagine what the New York Times would say. Oh, if we were to disinvite the president from the State of the Union, he can mail it in, he can fax it in, he can email it to John Boehner. John Boehner should send him a note saying, "I'll be happy to take your State of the Union by email, and we'll pin it up in the House of Representatives men's room. But you ain't coming here to give a speech. You ain't coming." No, that's something that's absolutely unthinkable. We can't possibly ever think or conceive of doing such a thing. Think of what the New York Times would say about us. Do you know, in North America right now, all kinds of legislatures, this, the head of state, province of Quebec, where the Queen's Viceroy is supposed to give the speech from the throne at the opening session of every parliament in Quebec City. And because chippy Quebec separatists like to pretend that they're not under the jackboot heel of the crown, but they're some kind of independent French-speaking republic, they don't let the Queen's Viceroy set foot in parliament to deliver the speech from the throne, which is the equivalent of the State of the Union. For 40 years, they've insulted. And they said, "No, you can't set foot in here." Jean Chrétien, the Canadian Prime Minister in Ottawa,
Wouldn't let the Queen in 2002, the Queen herself, give the speech from the throne in the Canadian Parliament in Ottawa because he felt she'd given him too lousy a seat at her mother's funeral a couple of months earlier. In other words, and you don't need a lot of cojones to stand up and tell the head of state, sorry, no thanks, you're not setting foot in the people's chamber. And be Canadians and even French cheese-eating surrender Quebecers managed to do it, but somehow it would be asking too much for the Republican House to show the same cojones as all these would-be effete, semi-French monarchical Canadians do. So the idea that he's going to be impeached when you can't even get him disinvited from the State of the Union. And if I could sound overheated about this, it's because I take this tearing up the Constitution business seriously, not just as a legal immigrant. I think it's very dangerous when you have people basically deciding what the laws are according to how they feel in the morning. These deputies in Grand Junction, Colorado. Why should we be surprised when policemen decide that a banana, off the top of their head, that the banana is a threatening weapon, you know, so they're riddling Carmen Miranda with bullets when she's appearing at the Rialto Grand Junction that night. Why should you be surprised when they decide, you know, a banana's a threat? When the president wakes up in the morning and decides to rewrite immigration law or Obamacare law, and as long as he wants to do that, he's not in good standing with the law, and the people's chamber, the people's house, should not let him set foot in it. Mark Stein in for Rush. Thanks for your call, Clara. Lots more to come.
You're listening to the EIB Network. Power Talk on the American Forces Radio Network.
Easy in sight. 30 seconds to drop point.
30 seconds!
In 1942, elements of the U.S. 509th Parachute Infantry spearheaded the Allied attack on Hitler's forces in North Africa.
15 seconds.
15 seconds!
It was the first combat airborne operation in U.S. history. Flying 1,600 miles at night from Britain, many of the Z-47 transports were diverted by communications problems.
Green light!
Green light! Let's go! 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 Go!
But several aircraft did make it to the two target airfields, and the airborne troops were successful in capturing both. Along with later jumps in North Africa and Southern Europe, this set the stage for the airborne invasion of Normandy. Airborne operations, part of American military history, and an important element of today's American military.
This is NIH Health Matters. For the first time, preliminary research using brain imaging technology has shown that low-key and attention-grabbing anti-smoking public service announcements, or ads, stimulate different... Dr. Stephen Grant at the National Institute on Drug Abuse explains that the attention-grabbing ads activate the back of the brain.
The visual areas of the brain, as well as auditory sensory areas of the brain, because there's a lot of rapidly changing information.
Dr. Grant says the findings suggest that the attention-grabbing format may impede retention. For more information on this study, visit www.nih.gov. Health Matters is produced by the National Institutes of Health, part of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
What I say, you already know, but you don't believe. You won't accept, you don't conceive. When you're inside your car, you feel safest of all. Are you safe? Are you? 2 tons of sheet metal in your hands. 2 tons don't run on autopilot. You have a mission. It's no collision. Hold the phone. Don't text. You're angling to be next. Oh, you've done it before. What's the harm? Just this once, there's no alarm. Got your hands on the wheel? No big deal. Brothers and sisters, you won't see it coming. You're off the road. Your life explodes. It's not worth it. Don't do it. You only think there's nothing to it. Put it down. Hang up. Pay attention to highway action. Behind the wheel, there is no such thing as a small distraction.
Join the conversation at decidetodrive.org. A public service message from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons, who would rather help keep your bones strong than put them back together.
Hey, I don't know where they come from, but they sure do come. I hope they're coming for me. And I don't know how they do it, but they do it good. And they do it for free. They give me cat scratch fever.
That's my version of Ted Nugent's Cat Scratch Fever, which came by way of request. I recorded that, I think it was last month. Ted Nugent did his great hard rockin' classic of it, whatever it was now, 35 years ago, something like that. And it's still one of his most popular songs when Ted does it. But I thought I'd do like a sort of pared down little version of it with bass and trailer. It's not a lounge lizard version. Mike, I'm insulted by it. Anyway, Ted himself, Ted Nugent, said I nailed the soulfulness of his classic song. Killer band, killer arrangement, killer attitude. That's what Ted Nugent said. And by the way, Ted Nugent is one of, I think he's only two Republican-leaning pop stars. The other one is Pat Boone. So it was a choice between doing that or one of Pat Boone's songs, because I felt they ought to be. And actually, I'm unfair. There's three Republican pop stars. There's Ted Nugent, there's Pat Boone, and there's one of the Oak Ridge Boys. One of the Oak Ridge Boys is rumored to have supported Bush in 2000. No one knows which Oak Ridge Boy it is. So don't be careless and pick on the wrong Oak Ridge Boy, because he might be a doctrinaire liberal and be enraged that you mistake him for his Bush-voting brother or whatever. But apparently one of the Oak Ridge Boys voted, supported. But that's Ted Nugent is, he's published by my publisher, Regnery, who published my new book, and they publish his cookbook, Kill It and Grit. And there's no truth to the rumor that after he heard my version of Cat Scratch Fever, that I turn up in the next edition of Kill It and Grill It as one of the recipes on page 257. Ted was very nice about my little record of Cat Scratch Fever. But anyway, that's available. You can get it at Amazon.com. You can get it from my website or whatever. A lot of people have emailed me in reaction to this banana story in Colorado, where two sheriff's deputies had to basically take down this guy and have charged him with a felony, menacing them with a banana. And many people have pointed out that this is one of those many occasions in life when life imitates Monty Python. 40 years ago, the Monty Python guys did a sketch about how to defend yourself against fresh fruit. They're all complaining. It begins, if you know the Monty Python sketch, they're all complaining about self-defense against fresh fruit, that they've done the melon, they've done the Logan berries, they've done the pomegranates, greengages, plums, mangoes, and they want to move on to self-defense against bananas. Sergeant John Cleese says, how to defend yourself against a man armed with a banana. Now, you, come at me with this banana. First, it's quite simple to defend yourself against a man armed with a banana. First of all, you force him to drop the banana. Then, second, you eat the banana, thus disarming him. You have now rendered him helpless. That's the Monty Python self-defense against fresh fruit sketch, when you're menaced by a man holding a banana. That was the way we used to deal with it 40 years ago. Now this guy in Grand Junction, Colorado, he actually did the Monty Python sketch. He enacted it on the streets of Grand Junction. He got a banana out of his pocket, and he's looking at a felony charge for menacing these two police officers. Mark Stein in Ferrari. Rush. On Open Line Friday, we'll take lots of your calls straight ahead. The EIP Network.
Political Talk Radio. Doug Wright. AFN Radio. Power Talk.
Then I called Mother. Thanks for sharing. Larry, would you like to address the group?
Hi, I'm Larry, and I'm a designated driver.
I'm Larry.
Well, it's been 2 weeks since my last drive, and I just wanted to say how satisfying it's been to be thought of as the responsible one in my group of friends, but I'm starting to feel like, you know, next time we go out, maybe I'd like to have a drink or two. Is that weird?
No, you shouldn't have to be the designated driver all the time. Switch off. Agree on who's going to be the guy before you head out, and over time, everyone gets to share in the fun and the responsibility.
When the group's going out for a few drinks, always pick a designated driver. It's a responsible thing to do. Okay, let's be clear about why I'm on this elliptical machine. It's not because I like working out. I'm not trying to build up my leg muscles or even train for a marathon. I'm on this thing every day to help maintain my weight. So, how are you maintaining your weight?
The key to successful weight control is making physical activity a part of your daily life. To learn more, contact your healthcare provider.
This is NIH Health Matters. A new study shows that specific variations or mutations in a particular gene can raise a man's risk of familial or inherited testicular germ cell cancer. Dr. Constantine Stratakis is with the Eunice Kennedy Shriver National Institute of Child Health and Human Development.
So the key finding here is that we found inactivating mutations in a gene that regulates cyclic AMP levels. Cyclic AMP mediates the effects of many of the hormones that regulate testicular function.
Dr. Stakis says cyclic AMP is one of the most ancient signaling pathways that regulates how cells respond to hormones. For more information, visit www.nih.gov. Health Matters is produced by the National Institutes of Health, part of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Roger that. Transitioning out of the military? Maybe you're looking for a federal job. Veterans may be eligible for special preferences that could help them land a federal job. Spouses of disabled vets are also eligible to take advantage of the veteran's preference. See if you're eligible for a 5-point or 10-point preference. Visit FedsHireVets.gov to start your federal job search.
Carmen Miranda, the John Manders. John Manders deserves credit for this. He says, was this fella arrested for his dangerous banana in Fort Junction, Colorado? Was he read his Carmen Miranda rights? I think that's the best one. That's the best one. If I do any more lousy fruit gags, I'm gonna have the fellas at GLAAD doing to me what I did to Phil Robinson. So I'm not gonna go down there. Malaysia Airlines has apologized for its tweet. Want to go somewhere, but don't know where. Malaysia Airlines, of course, they still haven't found that jet that is supposedly disappeared somewhere in the Indian Ocean. They still haven't recovered all the debris from that plane that was flying from the Netherlands to Kuala Lumpur that was blown out of the sky over Ukraine, those fellas thought they were going to Kuala Lumpur, but they didn't know where they were going. And Malaysia Airlines somehow, the chief rebuilt their business, managed to send out a promotional tweet going, want to go somewhere, but don't know where. There are some Black Friday bargains, you just do not want to go anywhere near. Mark Stein, in for Rush on Open Line Friday. We are going to take lots more of your calls as we discuss the immigration amnesty, the post-constitutional order, and Captain Ferguson in the hours ahead. Stick around.
We're here in the sleep lab where the fascinating breakthrough allows us to listen in on criminals while they're dreaming. And if I knew the probes just so, should we be able to hear his dreams?
What do I do with my keys? All right, well, I'll just be gone a sec. I don't need to lock the door while I'm writing down the
code. That's right, kid. Leave it unlocked. Well, there you have it. Scientific proof that when you leave doors unlocked and valuables in plain sight, it's a dream come true for criminals.
Hey, hon? Hon? What's on TV tonight?
Radio.
No, I mean on television.
Like I said, radio.
Honey, I'm asking what's on TV tonight.
Right. Today, our AFN satellite system was installed.
Oh.
And now we can get all the AFN radio channels to our television or stereo.
Let me see that remote.
Just go to do it.
They make hire and fire coaches and
temperatures. I had a feeling that was gonna happen.
Power talk on AFN radio gives you the most complete lineup of political talk radio shows found nowhere else in the world.
Have a minute to talk?
Yes, freely you may speak.
Being a trooper for the Senate is exciting and all, but I can't help but think of the future. I mean, what am I going to do when my time in the Grand Army's over?
Attend college you should.
College? Why college?
A degree you should learn. Improve your career. It will. The future, you're planning.
That sounds like a good idea. I'll stop by the base education office today and sign up for class. I'm not scared at all.
You will be. You will be.
I'm the strongest man in the universe.
Perhaps you are physically strong, but your intellectual strength pales in comparison to my own. Now watch as I demonstrate the way...
Whoa. So you're both either physically or mentally fit, but what about your spiritual fitness?
What's that?
Spiritual fitness. It can be something as small as having a good time with friends or taking leave and enjoying your favorite hobbies. Staying positive and motivated is just as important to your health as being physically and mentally fit.
Radio News. I'm Rita Foley. Gas is cheaper than it's been in a long time as many Americans return home from their Thanksgiving holiday travel. $2.77 a gallon this morning, 22 cents a gallon cheaper than it was a month ago. 50 cents a gallon cheaper than it was a year ago. If you're not traveling, maybe you're online on this Cyber Monday trying to find a bargain. Millions of us will spend billions of dollars online today. But Shopper Tracks' Bill Martin says you may be surprised to learn where we spend most of our money.
E-commerce, while important, still only represents about 8 to 9% of total retail, and then over 90% of all commerce is still taking place in the brick-and-mortar stores.
Now the case of a man who went on Facebook and threatened to brutally murder his estranged wife, shoot up a kindergarten class, and kill an FBI agent. The question before the Supreme Court this morning is whether that's free speech online. Here's our Sandy Kozell.
Anthony Alonis of Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, says he was just venting his anger over a broken marriage and never meant to threaten anyone. But his wife didn't see it that way. Neither did federal prosecutors. The jury can keep Alonis.
William Henderson, a lawyer, Hatchie Corporation of Texas, said in August that one of its employees had been killed in a carjacking in Egypt's western desert. The company did not identify the employee at the time. The Green Bay Packers beat the Patriots 26-21 yesterday. This is AP Radio News. Too many babies are sleeping with blankets and other items that could suffocate them, according to a new study. Here's our Ed Donahue.
Guidelines recommend no blankets, pillows, and other unsafe bedding in cribs. The National Institutes of Health and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention say the number of parents using blankets has dropped, but more than half are still doing it. Accidental suffocation in bed is the leading cause of injury-related death in infants. From 2000 to 2010, the rate doubled. The cases of sudden infant death syndrome have declined recently. There are alternatives to blankets. One-piece sleeper before keeping the child's bedroom at a comfortable temperature. temperature. I'm Ed Donahue.
Amazon is showing off its army of new robots designed to help workers meet the holiday shipping crunch. 15,000 robots on wheels can crisscross the floors of warehouses and deliver stacks of toys, books, and other products to employees. Says one, it's made the job a lot easier. Rita Foley, AP Radio News.
This is the Wall Street Journal report. I'm Jennifer Kishika. The Supreme Court tomorrow will consider a business battle over trademark rights for screws that has been in the court for more than 16 years. An extreme example of how cases headed for the high court can be matters of endurance. And so urgent legal matters occasionally catch fire and move quickly through the court. The average age for a high court case is nearly 6 years. 37% of cases since 2009 have taken longer. Employers in Hollywood are calling action as California legislators have worked to lure back the state's scattered entertainment industry. Jobs in the sector in Los Angeles County have been approaching pre-recession levels. October saw the highest local monthly employment in the motion picture and sound recording industries in 10 years. Novartis says a late-stage study showed little difference between one of its MS drugs and a placebo for treating a difficult form of the disease. On Wall Street, futures indicating a lower open this morning. This is the Wall Street Journal report.
From the Fox Sports studios in Los Angeles, Eddie Garcia.
Should we start seeing the NFL on Sunday Night Football, the big game, the AFC West, where the Broncos knock off the Chiefs in Kansas City 29-16, Jefferson won 6th Street. The Chiefs. Broncos are 9-3 with that win. Kansas City drops to 7-5 with the loss. In the late action on Sunday, game of the day was in Green Bay with the Packers. How about the Patriots for a 26-21 victory? New England's 7-game winning streak came to an end. Quarterback Tom Brady on the Patriots loss.
I wish we could have done some higher offense in the end. And that's why one more thing that may not be a game like that. So I've got to figure out how to score more points.
Both teams now 9-3 with the loss. Falcons surprised the Cardinals 29-18. Arizona's 9-3 with its second straight loss. Atlanta at 5-7 is on top of the NFC South and holding down a playoff spot. In early games of note, Drew Brees threw 5 touchdown passes, leading the Saints over the Steelers 35-32.
Our troops deserve the best. We are the best. Gravity, the party station on AFN.
I'm gonna die.
Hello. Manski?
Sure.
Sounds good. Santoro, what do you think?
Any time is fine.
Hi, nice job. You can't do this stuff.
今週1週間の目標、キャンドゥは留守番電話を折り返し、電話が残ってるんですね。では、今日習ったことを使って次の問題に答えましょう。留守電を残しておき、いい。どうなるかな。Leave a voicemail, okay?